To quickly get through your inbox and to get a good overview of what you need to action on in what order, I recommend that you set up a system for managing your email. If you keep everything in your inbox, you will quickly lose track of what needs to be done. In this video, you will learn how to set up a system in Outlook 2013 to quickly process and prioritize email.
About 10 years ago, before Outlook was as powerful as it is today, I used to organize my email into multiple folders. I had an enormous folder structure with multiple levels where I would manually organize my email. Needless to say, it was very time-consuming to manage and extremely inefficient. Let me show you how I manage my email today using Outlook 2013.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
Instead of having a full tree structure with different folders to organize my email, I just have three folders: Action, Read, and Archive. The Action folder contains emails that I need to action. These are then categorized: the ones that are urgent, that I need to follow up on right away, the ones I need to action, and then email I need to follow up on but I'm waiting for input from someone else. And finally, email that I have scheduled time in my calendar to follow up on. This folder is sorted by category so that the email I need to action urgently are on the top. The Read folder contains emails that I want to spend some more time to read properly, but they don't require me to action. Finally, I have the Archive folder. This is where I put emails that I'm done with, but I want to keep them as a reference. I organize this folder by conversation. This way, I can get a good overview of emails that are part of the same conversation, no matter when in time they were sent. Instead of dragging and dropping email to the different folders and applying categories to them manually, I use Quick Steps. Quick Steps enable you to perform a number of steps with just a click of a button. Now, let's see how I use this system and the Quick Steps to clean up my inbox. A good recommendation is to respond directly to an email that takes 2 minutes or less to action. Here I have an email from Jacob informing me about a change in the video production schedule. I'll click reply, and instead of a new window opening up, you can see that I can write my response in the original email. This quick response capability is new in Outlook 2013, and it saves a lot of time and minimizes the message window clutter on your screen. All right, great, thanks, and send. I want to keep this email as a reference, but it doesn't require me to action, so I'll click my Archive Quick Step, which moves the email to my Archive folder. Here's an email from Peter asking me to provide him with feedback on a presentation he's giving next week. Since this is not urgent, I'll reply, "Sure, I'll do it early next week," and send. I'll click the Quick Step Schedule, which takes the body of the email and creates an appointment for me. I'll change the date of the appointment to next week, and then I'll click the Scheduling Assistant to find a good time slot. I'll schedule an hour and click Save and Close. The email is then marked as scheduled and moved into my Action folder. Here I have an email from Sarah asking me to read through two documents as soon as possible. This is urgent, but I need more than 2 minutes to do it. So I'll click my quick step, Action Urgently. The email is flagged for urgent follow-up and moved into my action folder. Here are a number of email that I'll just delete. Even though I have a large delete button next to each email, it's easier for me to use the quick steps so that I don't have to move back and forth between the email and my quick steps. Here I have a partner asking me for the updated brochures that I still haven't received. I'll just respond to him that I'm still waiting to hear back and that I'll let him know as soon as I hear something. To make sure I don't forget to follow up on this email, I'll click the quick step Action Waiting for Input. The email is marked for follow-up and moved into my action folder. Here I have an email from Nora about an interesting article from McKinsey. I want to spend some time to read this, so I'll click Read. I'll continue to go through my inbox using the quick steps. When I've gone through all email and emptied my inbox, I'll go to the action folder. First, I'll go through the email that require urgent attention. I'll go through them one by one and respond appropriately. When I'm done with my email, I'll click my Archive quick step to clear the email from all follow-up flags and categories and move it to my Archive folder. By following this system, I have a clear overview of what needs to be done in what order. Let me show you how to set up this system. First, I'll create the folders. I'll right-click the inbox and select New Folder. I'll name it Action. I'll mark the Action folder and click By Date and change the sort order to Categories. I'll create another folder that I name Read, and then finally one that I name Archive. The folders are organized alphabetically, but unlike previous versions, Outlook 2013 lets me rearrange my folders in the order I want them. I'll mark the Archive folder and click By Date and select Show as Conversations and apply it to this folder. Next, I'm going to create the categories. I'll go back to my inbox. On the Home tab, click Categorize and then All Categories. By default, you'll already have a number of categories named by color. I'll mark the red category, click Rename, and then I'll name it 1 Action Urgently. I need to number my categories since these will be sorted alphabetically. Follow the same procedure until you've created categories for 2 Action, 3 Action Waiting for Input, and 4 Scheduled. Then click OK. Next, I'll create the quick steps. To create a quick step, click the little arrow in the quick steps section on the Home tab. Outlook comes with a number of predefined quick steps. Since I won't be using these, I'll just delete them by marking them one by one and pressing Delete. You can always restore them by clicking Reset to Default if you want them back. To create a new quick step, I'll click New and then Custom. I'll name it Action Urgently. I'll change the icon and select one with the exclamation mark. Now I need to choose an action. First, I'll add an action to categorize message. I'll select the category I created, call 1 Action Urgently. I'll add one more action to add a follow-up flag set to today. I'll add another action to move it to a folder, and here I'll select my action folder. And finally, I'll add one more action to mark it as unread. The reason I mark it as unread is that then I can see how many action items I have by just glancing at the action folder. I'll click Finish to finalize the quick step. To create the next quick step, I'll just click Duplicate. I'll rename it to just Action. I'll change the icon again and select a flag. Then I'll change the category to the 2 Action category, and then I'll click Finish. I'll duplicate again and make similar changes for the Action Waiting for Input quick step. Here, I'll also change the due date of the follow-up flag to no date, and then finish. To create the quick step for scheduling action items, I'll click New and then Custom. Here, I'll add the following actions. Create an appointment with text of message. Clear categories. Categorize message with the four schedule category that we created. Clear flags for message, mark as unread, and move to the action folder. I'll create one more custom quick step that I name read with the following actions. Move to folder, select the read folder we've created, and mark as unread. I'll create one more custom quick step that I'll name archive. Here I'll add the following actions. Clear categories, clear flags on message, mark as read, and move to folder and select the archive folder. Finally, the most important one, which is delete. This you should use a lot. Here I'll just add the action delete message. Okay, we are done with our quick steps. When you finish your quick steps, it should look like this. Creating these quick steps is a bit tedious, but once you've done it, you'll have a very effective system for how to manage your email.